push area that lets you take the presser foot super high to jump over heavy, heavy seams. That's a nice feature. Over to the last machine again, we talk about the presser foot screw, the ankle, the presser foot itself, and the presser foot lifter. So this lowers and raises your presser foot. Now down here is the needle plate, and on this machine, the slide plate. As we move to the next machine, we have a needle plate, but there is no slide plate covering the entrance to the bobbin area. On this next machine, there's our needle plate again. No slide plate because our bobbin access is through this front door. And on the next machine, we do have a needle plate here and a slide plate here. And that's what covers your bobbin area. Speaking about bobbins and bobbin cases, this machine has a drop-in bobbin. I'm going to pull up this tab and take out this bobbin. That is the bobbin. The bobbin goes into the machine like that. This tab folds down. That's the bobbin holding mechanism. Then we would slide the plate back and we'd be ready to sew. On this machine, you find the bobbin and the bobbin case in this area. On the next machine, it's the same situation. The front door opens. There's your bobbin and the bobbin case. And on the next machine, to get to the bobbin and bobbin case, you actually lift this door and you reach in from the side. It's a little harder to do to get the bobbin and the bobbin case out. We'll talk a little bit more about this later. We'll close that down. So let's talk about getting prepared to sew. And to do that, we thread our machine and we wind a bobbin. One of the first things that you need to know is about needles. Most sewing machines, almost all but the oldest of the old of the old, have a flat side of the needle and then a rounded side of the needle. Now, if you have a machine that has the slide plate come towards you, the flat part is going to go to the back of the machine. So on this machine, this faces towards me. I'm going to insert the needle with the flat part to the back. Now, you want to make sure you're always all the way up in the shaft. Don't go halfway. Go all the way up until the needle is stopping. It's totally stopped. And then just hand tighten the screw as tight as you can get it. You don't need to use a screwdriver for this. Now, two things that you do whenever you start to thread your sewing machine. This is very, very important. Reach back and raise your presser foot. That presser foot lifter should be in the up position. The presser foot is up. The second thing you do is go over to the balance wheel. Now rotate the balance wheel always towards you. You want to rotate the balance wheel until the take-up lever is at its highest. This particular machine has what we call a horizontal spool pin. And so what happens is that the thread is going to mount on the spool pin and unreel this way. Now there are some things you need to know about this. Number one is when you put the spool of thread on the pin, you want to push it to the far right as far as you can. You don't want this kind of thing happening here. So move it all the way to the right. And then you're going to cap the spool of thread so that there's no movement this way. Now, let me show you something different. I'm going to show you up here. I'm going to try a different brand of thread. This is another brand of thread, another kind of a configuration. It probably looks pretty familiar to you. The funny thing about this manufacturer is that they very conveniently put a little slit right in the edge of the thread, and that's what it's for, is to hold our thread nice and neat. But you can imagine if I've got this thread on the spool pin, and as this thread pulls off horizontally, there's every likelihood that the thread is going to get caught in that notch. So what you must know is that if you have thread with the rim where it is very rough or it's got a little slot, make sure you use the widest spool cap you can. This is the wide section towards the spool of thread versus when I had the skinny spool on, I used the skinny portion closest to the thread. So we're going to cap this thread. On this machine, you have a thread guide right here. It's a little hole. Now, in the past, we've always taken our single strand of thread and tried to poke it through.